Welcome students. In today's class, we are going to discuss about some common allergic reactions and some of the tests that are used to diagnose the allergy in a particular human being. The first allergic reaction that we have is called the hay fever. The hay fever is a particular allergic reaction that is caused due to the pollen grains. And since the pollen grains are coming from the flowers, so they are more common at some particular seasons when the flowers bloom. The hay fever is actually caused by the inhalation process. So the nose is the entry route for this particular allergic reaction. What are the symptoms and what happens in hay fever? Is that the inner lining of the nose that is producing the mucus, it becomes inflamed and it produces excess mucus. Since it is producing excess mucus, the nasal passage becomes blocked, the runny nose happens, continuous sneezing, watery eyes, itchy eyes, etc. are the symptoms that are experienced by the patient. Next allergic reaction is the asthma. So asthma is a condition of the respiratory passage. We know that the respiratory passage is having a windpipe or the trachea. Now the trachea goes down up to the level of the lung, and as it reaches the lung, it will get divided into two parts, left part and the right part, that will enter the left lung and the right lung respectively. Now these two parts are called the bronchioles. The bronchioles are having some smooth muscles on the walls of it, which are in normal situation relaxed condition. So the bronchial tube is wider and air can pass through it very easily. But when a person is affected with asthma, that is, the bronchial tube gets inflamed, that is swollen and reddened, and the muscles on the wall of the bronchial tube gets tightened. That is, they are not in relaxed condition anymore like the normal bronchial tube. Rather, they are in contracted situation, and the contracted smooth muscle and the inflamed bronchial tube makes the tube or inside passage of the air very narrow, and it is also blocked with a lot of mucus, so the air passing becomes very difficult. The person faces a lot of difficulty in breathing, and that difficult breathing or pressurized breathing is called wheezing because it makes a particular peculiar sound. Now, as the person is not able to breathe normally, he is also suffering from nervousness and worry. Asthma is treated by the drugs that are working on the smooth muscle of the bronchial wall and relaxing the muscles into its normal condition so that the tube gets again distended and the passage for air movement gets wider again. The next most common allergic reaction is called hives or urticaria. In hives or urticaria, what happens is that swollen, pale, red bumps are present all over the skin and it becomes very itchy. So that is known as hives or urticaria. Up to this, the allergic reactions that we have studied about all were some local infection. That is, a particular organ or particular system of the human body was getting affected. In hay fever, the nasal passage and the respiratory tract would get affected. In asthma as well, the respiratory tract, the bronchioles and the trachea will get affected. In hives, the skin will get affected. But in case of anaphylaxis that we are going to know about, this is a systemic response. That means that not only a single system or single organ of the human body gets affected, but a multiple systems are getting affected simultaneously. So we can always guess that it is a more severe form of allergic reaction, and this affects the body in a very fatal way. If a person infected with anaphylaxis is not treated in time with proper medication, that person is going to die because it is that sort of a fatal reaction. Now, what are the different systems that are being affected in anaphylaxis? First is the respiratory system or the airways. So the person is having a blocked airway, and then coughing, sneezing, shortness of breath, asthma, chest pain or tightness in the chest, etc. So all of these are the symptoms that are shown from the affected respiratory system. Now the brain system is also affected because the person is struck with anxiety, confusion, headache, feeling of something is about to happen. So the person is very delusional. Next, the cardiovascular system is also affected because the heart is affected. So the blood pressure is decreased, then loss of consciousness, dizziness, and faint or pale or blue color like blood. So the oxygen is reaching the heart very little amount. The blood is not reaching the heart in a lot of amount, efficient amount. The skin is affected. Hives, swelling, itchiness, widespread redness, etc. is shown. And also the digestive system is affected because the person is feeling the nauseated, and a vomiting feeling is also there. The person might also have diarrhea and etc. So that is when the anaphylaxis come, and that is why the anaphylaxis is called the systemic response. The first test that is done to diagnose the different allergies or the different allergens a particular person is allergic to is called the skin prick test. In skin prick test, what is done is that the underside skin of the arm of the person is divided into different quadrants with the help of a marker, and it is marked with the particular allergen that is applied here with the help of a particular needle, which is just pricking the skin a little bit and entering or putting the allergen, particular allergen, into that area of the skin. Just a little bit prick. The allergen solution is placed on the skin. Now, if that human being or if that person is allergic to that particular allergen, he will show positive test. What is that? The skin will show a small red itchy bump. And if in some quadrant the red itchy bump is not shown, that then we can conclude that the person is not affected with that particular allergen put into that quadrant. So from the left hand side picture, as we can see, the skin of the person is divided into 10 quadrants. So he has been tested against 10 allergens. Now we can see after the skin prick test has been done that he is developing the red itchy small bump on the quadrant number 2, quadrant number 4, quadrant number 5 and quadrant number 7. Suppose quadrant number 2 has the allergen animal fur, quadrant number 4 has the allergen peanut, quadrant number 5 has the allergen insect bite, and quadrant number 4 is having the allergen soy. So we can conclude that this particular person is allergic to the allergens that has been applied in the quadrants 2, 4, 5 and 7. And he is non-allergic to the allergens that has been applied in the quadrant 1, 3, 6, 8, 9 and 10. The second test that is done is the quantitative blood test. So the blood test measures the concentration of the specific immunoglobulins in the blood. So as we have seen, when the particular allergen was entering into the body, our immune system was showing some chemical reactions in stepwise manner against that particular allergen. In that reaction, we had seen that the plasma cells a particular cell of the immune system was secreting a protein which was called the immunoglobulin. Now, this immunoglobulin protein is specific for every specific allergen. That is, the immunoglobulin against the pollen grain is not similar to the immunoglobulin against egg. So, there are specific immunoglobulins produced against the specific allergen. In blood tests to diagnose the allergy, we measure the concentration of that specific immunoglobulins against the specific allergens. So, multiple allergens can be detected from a single blood sample if the blood sample is treated with different allergens in different portions. And if that person is allergic to some particular allergen, that sample of the blood will have immunoglobulin, and from that we can conclude that this person is having allergy from this particular allergen. So we measured the concentration of the antibody or the immunoglobulin IgE, which is produced when the blood is mixed with a series of allergens in a laboratory. The blood test is always better than the skin prick test because it is a quantitative test and it measures the specific amount of immunoglobulin. So it is a more determinative step.